Cada vez que lo oigo hablar.
Hi, everybody.
Cada vez
que lo oigo hablar.
Storytime, bienvenidos a Tiempo de Cuento para Familia Virtual. My name is Ms. Yentl, this is Ms. Ofilia.
Hi, hola.
And I have a friend that helps me out for the story time. Her name is Bella. Let me see if she's ready. Bella, everyone's ready. It's story time. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited to see you. Hi, Ms. Ofilia.
Hi, Bella. You look lovely today.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you.
I'm excited for tonight's story time, or today's. And did you already look at the letter of the week, Bella? No, I haven't. Ooh, it's a Q. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And what sound does that letter make, Bella? It's a K, K, kind of like a K. Yeah, you're right, Bella. And what about in Spanish? It's kind of the same. You say, it's like the same sound. And what words are we going over today, Bella? We're doing quick, rápido. And then we're doing quack. Like a pato, a duck. Oh, and then we're doing a queen, reina. And are there very many words that start with a Q in Spanish, Bella? No, there aren't. A lot of them are like questions, like que and
quien.
Quien. Oh, that's a good one. Who? And yeah, you're right, Bella. There aren't very many. Oh, I know one. It's queso.
Oh,
cheese. You're right, Bella.
Yeah, that's my favorite food.
That's a good one. I love cheese. My pizza, my nachos, everything. Mm-hmm. You're right, Bella. That's a good one. All right, now you have a song for them, right, Bella? Oh, yes. Let me get ready. My name is Bella. A mí me gusta leer y también bailar. Now it's time for story time. Now you're gonna read some books. So adios, goodbye. Bye guys, see you later.
Bye, Bella. See you later.
Alright, now it's time for our very first book. And it is a big book. Called Quick as a Cricket. Rápido como un grillo.
And it's by Audrey Wood and illustrated by Dawn Wood. I'm quick as a cricket.
Soy tan rápido como un grillo.
I'm as slow as a snail.
Soy tan despacio como un caracol.
I'm as small as an ant.
Soy tan pequeño como una hormiga.
I'm as large as a whale.
Soy tan grande como una ballena.
Wow. I think we're working on opposites. Estamos hablando de opuestos, right? Mm-hmm. I'm as sad as a basset.
Estoy tan triste como un basset.
I'm as happy as a lark.
Soy tan feliz como una alondra.
I'm as nice as a bunny.
Soy tan amable como un conejo.
I'm as mean as a shark.
Soy tan malo como un tiburón.
I'm as cold as a toad.
Soy tan frío como un sapo.
I'm as hot as a fox.
Soy tan caliente como un zorro.
He was being chased.
He was.
I'm as weak as a kitten.
Estoy tan débil como un gatito.
I'm as strong as an ox.
Estoy tan fuerte como un buey.
I'm as loud as a lion.
Tan ruidoso como un león.
I'm as quiet as a clam.
Soy tan callado como una almeja.
I'm as tough as a rhino.
Soy tan fuerte como un rinoceronte.
I'm as gentle as a lamb.
Soy tan gentil como una oveja.
I'm as brave as a tiger.
Soy tan valiente como un tigre.
I'm as shy as a shrimp.
Soy tan tímido como un camarón.
I'm as tame as a poodle.
Soy tan manso como un caniche.
I'm as wild as a chip.
Soy tan salvaje como un chimpancé.
I'm as lazy as a lizard.
Soy tan flojo como una lagartija.
I'm as busy as a bee.
Soy tan ocupado como una abeja.
Put it all together.
Ponlo todo junto.
And you've got me.
Y me tienes a mí.
The end.
Yay. Yay. Good job. Good one. All right, next you're gonna stand up. You can help us shake our sillies out.
Good idea.
Do it together.
Gotta shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Wiggle my waggles away. I gotta clap, clap, clap my crazies out. Clap, clap, clap my crazies out. Clap, clap, clap my crazies out and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta jump, jump, jump my jiggles out. Jump, jump, jump my jiggles out. Jump, jump, jump my jiggles out and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta yawn, yawn, yawn my sleepies out. Yawn, yawn, yawn my sleepies out. Yawn, yawn, yawn my sleepies out and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out and wiggle my waggles away. And wiggle my waggles away.
It's time for our next book, and this one's called Giggle, Giggle, Quack. I'll grab that.
It's by Doreen Cronin.
Yes. It's silly. It's a silly book. Oh, I see duck. Okay. Farmer Brown was going on vacation. He left his brother, Bob, in charge of the animals.
El granjero Brown se iba de vacaciones y dejó a su hermano Bob a cargo de los animales.
I wrote everything down for you. Just follow my instructions and everything will be fine. But keep an eye on Duck. He's troubled.
Te lo he escrito todo aquí. Vigila, Pato. Es muy travieso.
Farmer Brown thought he heard Giggle and Snickers as he drove away, but he couldn't be sure.
El granjero Brown creyó oír burlas y risitas cuando se alejó en el auto, pero no estaba seguro.
Bob gave Duck a good long stare and went inside.
Bob miró fijamente a Pato y entró a la casa.
He read the first note. Tuesday night is pizza night, not the frozen kind. The hens prefer anchovies.
Entonces leyó la primera nota. Los martes por la noche toca pizza y no congelada. Las gallinas la prefieren con anchoas.
Giggle, giggle, cluck.
Ha, ha, hee, hee, cluck.
29 minutes later, there was a hot pizza in the barn.
29 minutos más tarde, todos en el establo comían pizza caliente.
Bob checked on the animals before he went to bed. Everything was just fine.
Bob le echó una vistazo a los animales antes de acostarse. Todo estaba en orden.
Wednesday is bath day for the pigs. Wash them with my favorite bubble bath and dry them off with my good towels.
El miércoles es el día de bañar a los cerdos. Lávalos con mi jabón de espuma favorito y sécalos con las toallas buenas.
Remember, they have very sensitive skin.
Recuerda que tienen una piel muy sensible.
Giggle, giggle, oink.
Ha, 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 hee, hee, oink.
Bob had all the pigs washed in no time.
Bob bañó a los cerdos en poco tiempo.
It's like, it's very relaxed. In
es como un spa. Mm-hmm. They're like at the spa.
Pig spa. Mm-hmm. Farmer Brown called home on Wednesday night to check in.
El granjero Brown llamó a casa el miércoles por la noche para ver cómo iba todo.
Did you feed the animals like I wrote in the note?
¿Le diste de comer a los animales como decía la nota?
He asked. Done.
Claro.
Replied Bob, counting 7 empty pizza boxes.
Contando 7 cajas de pizza vacías.
Lots of pizza. Did you see my note about the pigs?
¿Viste la nota sobre los cerdos?
All taken care of.
Todo bajo control,
said Bob proudly. Are you keeping a very close eye on Duck?
¿Estás vigilando a Pato?
He asked. Bob gave Duck a good long stare. Duck was too busy sharpening his pencil to notice.
Bob miró fijamente a Pato. Pato estaba muy ocupado afilando un lápiz y no se enteró de nada.
What's he need a pencil for?
¿Qué necesita un lápiz?
Just keep him in the house, ordered Farmer Brown.
No lo dejes salir de la casa.
He's a bad influence on the cows.
Es una mala influencia para las vacas.
Giggle, giggle, moo.
Ha, ha, hee, hee, moo.
Giggle, oink.
Ha, ha, oink.
Giggle, quack.
Hee, hee, quack.
Thursday night is movie night. It's the cow's turn to pick.
El jueves por la noche toca cine. Eligen las vacas.
Giggle, giggle, moo.
Ha, ha, hee, hee, moo.
Bob was in the kitchen popping corn. Just as the animals settled in to watch The Sound of Music, the phone rang.
Bob hacía palomitas en la cocina. Los animales se acomodaban para ver el sonido de la música cuando sonó el teléfono.
The only thing Farmer Brown heard on the other end was giggle, giggle, quack. Giggle, moo, giggle, oink.
Lo único que llegó a oír el granjero Brown fue ha, ha, hee, hee, quack, ha, ha, moo, hee, hee, oink.
Uh-oh. Duck!
Pato!
Screamed Farmer Brown. It's for you, Bob.
Es para ti, Bob.
There he is. Does not look happy.
Did Farmer Brown write all those notes? ¿Escribió las notas el granjero Brown?
No, I think it was Pato.
I think it was Duck. Yeah, fue el Pato. Qué mañoso.
He is trouble.
Well, speaking of ducks, we have a little song about ducks. Tenemos una canción de patos.
I have like little friends that are helping me out for this one.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. You got them all? They're kind of hard to wrangle up there. Here we go. They're little ducks.
Patitos.
Let's count our ducks. Make sure they're all there.
Okay.
Ready?
One, two, three, four, five.
Y en español, por favor.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco.
You can use your fingers for this one. And we also have a papara.
Papapato.
You might know this song. We're going to substitute the word pato for duck, which is the word duck in Spanish. Okay? Sing it with us if you know it. Ready?
Five little patos went out one day, over the hill and far away. Papa Pato said, quack, 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 but only four little patos came waddling back.
One, two, three, four. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. See, four fingers. Cuatro dedos.
Four little patos went out one day, over the hill and far away. Papa Pato said, quack, 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 but only three little patos came waddling back.
One, two, three. Uno, dos, tres.
Three little patos went out one day, over the hill and far away. Papa Pato said, quack, 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 but only two little patos came waddling back.
One, two. Uno, dos.
Two little patos went out one day, over the hill and far away. Papa Pato said, quack, 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 but only one little pato came waddling back.
Oh my goodness, just one, solamente uno.
One little pato went out one day, over the hill and far away. Papa Pato said, quack, 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 but then no little patos came waddling back.
Oh no. No little bundles went out one day over the hill and far away. Papa Pato said, quack, 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 quack! I think he's mad. And then all five patos came waddling back. Quack, 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 you're grounded. Quack, 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 quack. Uh-oh. Go to your room. I think they're in trouble.
They are.
Oh, well. They'll be okay. Yeah. I think it's time for Arturo to come out and say hi.
Yes, exciting.
Come here, Arturo, are you ready? Arturo, oh goodness, Arturo. Oh, gosh. Arturo, what are you doing in there, Arturo? Arturo, come out! Hola, mis amigos, hi, my friends! Hi, Miss Yentl! I'm so excited to be here, hello! Oh, Arturo, we're happy you're here too. Are you ready to sing your song? I'm ready! Okay, let's go. My name is Arturo, and I like to read, especially about monos that swing from trees. So listen, mis amigos, come to the library where you can hear cuentos and a singing monkey. Oh, that was lovely, Arturo. Thank you. Thanks, Miss Yentl! Is it nursery rhyme time?
Oh, it is. Let's see what our nursery rhymes are.
Ah, it's our months of the year rhyme, which we do every week. It's to the tune of Frere Jacques, and we just learn our months in English and Spanish. Will you sing it with us, please? I would love to! Okay, here we go.
January, enero, February, febrero, March and April, marzo y abril, May and June, mayo y junio, July, August, julio, agosto, September, septiembre, October, November, octubre, noviembre, December, diciembre.
Yay! What's next, Miss Yentl?
Let's see, what's next? Oh, it's little Miss Maria.
It's little Miss Muffet, the Wizard of Spanish sprinkled in.
That's right, little Miss Muffet. Here we go, let's try it, ready? Little Miss Amaria sat in her silla, eating her beans and arroz.
Yum, yum! There came a big araña. That's a spider! And that was very extraña. She screamed in a very loud voice. Ah! She was scared of a spider. That's so silly. He seems so nice.
Yeah, he does seem like a nice spider, doesn't he?
Arturo, it's time for our pre-literacy skill. Every week we practice a different pre-literacy skill. There are five of them, and today's skill is, what does it say? It says background knowledge, prior knowledge about the world. All that means is everything your kids learn while they're out and about, when they're at home, everything you tell them, that's all background knowledge. Like, we all know that pigs live on a farm. That's background knowledge. It wasn't something you had to go see or explore. You read it in a book and that's how you know it, or your mom told you, or whatever, right? Oh, well, that makes sense, yeah. So background knowledge is very important, because the more background knowledge you have, the more you have to pull from when you're ready to start to learn to read. That's so cool! It is. We have one more song left. Is it the alphabet song? It is the alphabet song. I don't remember what it starts with. Oh, that's okay. I think Magenta knows.
It's an A.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Will you sing it with me?
Yeah.
Let's sing it all together. Ready?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
Yay! Now it's time for you to stand up, because we're gonna go swimming! Oh my goodness, it is time to go swimming. That was so quick. This is called The Goldfish Song by Laurie Berkner.
Lots of little fish were sleeping on a rock in the bottom of the ocean. They lifted up their heads and they shook out their tails and they said, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming. Yeah,
let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they were a little bit dirty, so they took a shower. And they washed their hair, and they washed their ears, and they washed their tummies, and they washed their very long fishy beards, and they washed their noses, and they washed their toeses, and then they said,
wait a minute, we're fish.
We are
fish. Don't take showers.
Let's go swimming, let's go swimming.
Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. They put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they decided to ride their bicycles. So they rode to the left, and they rode to the right, and they rode all day, yay, and they rode all night, 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 night. They rode down the hill, and then faster still, and then they said,
wait a minute, we're fish.
We
don't ride bicycles.
Let's go swimming,
let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
Then the little fish got so very, very tired that they came back to the rock. And they put down their heads and they put down their tails and they took a little nap. And when they woke up, they decided to brush their teeth. So they got out their toothbrush and their toothpaste, and they squeezed a little on. They really liked the taste. Then they put it in their mouth. They brushed north and south. And then they said,
wait a minute, we're fish.
We don't brush our teeth. Let's go swimming,
let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean. Let's go swimming, let's go swimming. Yeah, let's go swimming, let's go swimming, let's go swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
Excellent swimming, everyone. Good job.
Very good.
Okay, next we have a flannel story for you. And this flannel story is called Dear Zoo, which is Querido Zoológico. So it's got that Q in Spanish. So I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet.
Le escribí al zoológico para que me mandara una mascota.
They sent me...
Me mandaron un...
Let's see. What do you think it is? ¿Qué puede ser? An elephant!
Un elefante!
He was too big.
Estaba muy grande.
I sent him back.
Regresé.
I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet.
Le escribí al zoológico para que me mandaran una mascota.
They sent me...
Me mandaron un...
Okay, what do you think it is? ¿Qué puede ser? Some big long box. It's a...
Ooh,
a giraffe!
And a jirafa.
Oh, but he was too tall.
Estaba muy alto.
So I sent him back.
Regresé.
I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet.
Le escribí al zoológico para que me mandaran una mascota.
¿Qué puede ser? What do you think it is?
Let's see.
Maybe
some hair.
They sent me a...
Me mandaron un...
Lion!
Un león!
Oh, but he was too fierce.
Era muy feroz.
I sent him back.
Lo regresé.
I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet.
Le escribí al zoológico para que me mandaran una mascota.
They sent me...
Me mandaron un...
Ready? A camel!
Camello.
Oh, but he was too grumpy.
Era muy gruñón.
So I sent him back.
Lo regresé.
I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet.
Escribí al zoológico para que me mandaran una mascota.
From the zoo, del zoológico, What do you think is in there?
Oh, it's a basket.
Let's see. It's a snake!
Serpiente.
Oh, he's too scary!
Mucho miedo.
I sent him back. I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet.
Le escribí al zoológico para que me mandara una mascota.
Oh, this box looks promising. It's a good size.
Aww.
What do you think it could be? ¿Qué puede ser? Oh, it was a monkey!
Mono.
Like an Arturo. He was too naughty.
Era muy travieso.
So I sent him back.
Lo regresé.
I wrote to the zoo to send me a pet.
Escribí al zoológico para que me mandaran otra mascota.
Oh, this looks good. Esto se ve interesante.
Small,
algo chiquito. Let's see what it is. Vamos a ver qué es. It's a frog! But he was too jumpy.
Pero saltaba mucho.
So I sent him back.
Lo regresé.
I finally, the zoo wrote to me and sent me this pet.
Finalmente, el zoológico me mandó esta mascota.
It says, from all your friends at the zoo. De todos tus amigos en el zoológico. ¿Qué puede ser? What could it be? I don't know. Let's look. Are you ready? Ready? Oh, it's a puppy!
Perrito.
It's perfect.
Perfecto.
I kept him.
Me quedé con el
PFP. Yay! Good job. Okay, our last book for you today for the letter Q is about the Queen, Her Royal Highness. And it's a tour of London, this book. So if you've ever been to London or if you'd ever like to go, this is a good book to check out. It's called The Queen's Hat, El Sombrero de la Reina by Steve Antony.
The queen was on her way to visit someone very special when the wind went.
La reina estaba en camino a visitar a alguien muy especial cuando el viento hizo swish.
The wind took the queen's favorite hat right off her head.
El viento se llevó el sombrero favorito de la reina de su cabeza.
It soared high above the queen. It whooshed high above the queen's men.
Voló alto sobre la reina y sobre los hombres de la reina.
The wind was so strong that it swept the queen's hat all the way to...
El viento estaba tan fuerte que llevó el sombrero hasta...
Trafalgar Square.
La plaza de Trafalgar.
And all through...
Y por todo...
London Zoo.
El zoológico de Londres.
And she was on a giraffe, not a jirafa. And all along.
Y por todo.
The London Underground.
Ah, el metro de Londres.
And all around.
Y por todo alrededor.
The London Eye.
El ojo de Londres.
And all across.
Y a través de él.
Tower Bridge.
El puente de Londres.
And all over.
Y por todo.
Big Ben.
Big Ben, mira.
Whoa. Wow. It's all the way up here.
Can you see it, Luis?
Where it sailed up farther into the sky.
Donde voló en lo alto del cielo.
Swoosh.
Bye, hat. Adios. Adios.
Until at last, the queen and all the queen's men floated gently down.
Hasta que finalmente la reina y todos sus hombres flotaron suavemente para abajo. How did they float down? ¿Cómo flotaron?
Umbrellas.
Sombrillas, yeah. Like Mary Poppins.
To Kensington Palace.
Al Palacio de Kensington.
Along with the queen.
Junto con...
Hat.
El sombrero de la reina. Who caught it? ¿Quién lo pescó?
Would anyone like a cup of tea?
¿Alguien le gustaría una taza de té?
The end.
Yay! We hope you enjoyed that tour of London and that you enjoyed our family story time today featuring the letter Q. We hope you join us next week. We'll be here every Tuesday afternoon to do English and Spanish family bilingual story time for you. Wednesday mornings at 10, there's infant story time. Thursday at 2, is big kids story time. And toddler time's at 10 a.m. on Fridays. So we would love it if you joined us for all of that. Plus, we have all sorts of other special posts Yentl and Stephanie like to do crafternoons for you. Miss Debbie will be doing a My Very Own Book Club. We'll have between book club posts, all kinds of good stuff for everybody at home. So be sure to follow us on Facebook at Smith Public Library or check our website at wileytexas.gov/library. All the information you need is there. All right, are you ready to do our goodbye song, Miss Yentl?
Ready.
Okay, first time we're gonna do it slow so everybody can learn it. It goes like this. Adios, amigos, adios. Adios, it means goodbye. Adios, amigos, adios. We hope to see you next time. Let's speed it up just a little bit. Do it a little bit faster. Adios, amigos, adios. Adios, it means goodbye. Adios, amigos, adios. We hope to see you next time. Let's do it even faster, I bet you can, yeah. Adios, amigos, adios. Adios, it means goodbye. Adios, amigos, adios. We hope to see you next time. Do you think we can try it super lightning fast?
I think so.
Oh, I think we can do it. Let's try it just to be silly. But first we have to shake it out. So everybody get it all out, shake it out, get loose. Get a nice strong stay so you don't fall over. Put your hands together, get ready to clap. Take a deep breath. Adios, amigos, adios, 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 adios